think we messed with the curve on our couch.
The phenomenon formerly known as global warming. Did you know, Steve, that it's changing?
I did.
Why? Because that phrase is just not catching on, apparently.
Yeah, people don't get the term global warming, and surveys show that people are turned off by it. It's over-publicized and politicized. So now environmentalists want to rebrand, but if they don't like global warming, Frank Luntz, the author of Words That Work, what should they say instead of global warming?
Well, the amazing thing, or to me the amusing thing, is that back 7 years ago when we did this research and we found that the American people were much more connected to climate change than global warming, all the environmental groups across the country went crazy. They were yelling and screaming that this is anti-environment, that this is just a word game. But now even Al Gore uses the phrase climate change, because the American people see global warming as something that's outside their control, mm-hmm. as something that is more theoretical. Climate change is something they can relate to. It's something that's more localized, more personalized, more humanized. Mm-hmm. And what the environmental community has realized is it's got to stop shouting at people. And if it wants to get its message heard,
right.
it's got to use language and communication style that pulls people in rather than pushes them away.
So you agree with this name change?
If you care about the air, you care about the water, and you believe in this phenomenon, then this is a smart name
sure.
change. But again, to me, the funny thing is the very people who are now changing their name
right.
were the people who went hysterical 5 years ago when people like me suggested you ought to change the name.
To climate change. And in fact, you're an
Correct.
Expert at this because you rebranded it. Once upon a time, they used to refer to it as the estate tax, but that wasn't really, you know, estate, that's when I die and stuff like that. But you came up with?
The death tax.
The death tax, which is used today.
Estates are what wealthy people
right.
like you all at Fox and Friends will leave
yeah.
to your children. Because you're so well paid at the network.
Yeah, right.
A death tax is what happens when you die,
right.
and people get so outraged over it. And yet the fact is, when you tax,
sure.
you only pay the tax at death,
yes.
so it's appropriate.
All right, so the words do make a huge difference. Let's take a look at some of the other examples that we have. Remember when ValueJet crashed? I think it was that Everglades
down
that
Florida,
crashed
yeah.
down in Florida in 96, and then they changed their name to AirTran. You know what's interesting, Frank? I remember when this happened, and I thought, oh, there's a new airline out there.
Because people, even though that crash was so tragic, people do not relate the new name to the old name, the new company to the old company. You know what? It worked. But as you said, sometimes you don't want to change the name. The idea of New Coke was the dumbest thing anyone could have done.
Right.
Because nobody wanted New Coke. They wanted the original formula, the original taste.
So that was a failure. But then you look at the another successful rebranding. Camel came up with Joe Camel, and suddenly it was cool to a whole generation of younger smokers to light up.
Well, I'm going to leave that to others. There are some times when you shouldn't be rebranding something, when the product should are better off just left alone. But I'll tell you, I'll give you another example.
Yeah.
If you call a soft drink a carbonated drink, people
yeah.
think of the chemicals. But if you call it sparkling, they think of the taste and they think of how it makes them feel.
Sounds so
another
tingly.
Example,
wow.
you call a drink a diet drink, people think of what's put into it.
Yeah.
When you call it light, Pepsi Light, Coke Light, just Bud Light.
Uh-huh.
People think that it's less calories. They think of the stuff that's been taken out rather than what's been put in.
Interesting.
Very interesting. People sit around offices all across the country and think of these words all day long. Franks, you're one of them.
It's my
words
life,
that
by
work.
The way.
I know. Thanks for filling us in on your secrets.
Thank you.
Somebody who